thicker, and it just keeps getting harder, and I'm we'll be right back.
Told to expect it, I began my descent down the cold granite steps. And who could have turned among those I can fight in? I think that I know what I haven't known yet. Cause a week is a month and a week. When you're reaching, just pushes it further away. With your past and your future precisely divided, am I that moment?
Don't take another.
I haven't decided.
Don't take another.
I haven't decided.
Don't take another.
to the sea and the tunnels and the pockets of the sun. You gave it to me, but I really don't want it. I came out on top of my broken drum. Cause a week is a month and an hour a day. When all the change just pushes further away. What's the return on the faith I provided? I think that we'll be right back. catch all the ride. And we're glad, 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 glad. And we're glad, glad, glad that you're alive. Thank you.
Thank you.
here, the mission's clear. Tell us anything before we slip into the night. You want something to drink? Steal away before the dawn and bring us back the news. Please wipe it from your shine. Scores, leaning with his cry. Sanctuary reports the bride, a monkey on his thigh. A dust of rules, a clog my nose, before I could think twice. Despite the stuff that bubbled up, I gave some last advice. The flesh from Satan's arms will make the rubens so cruel. You got the chance from your pain, worthless swapping ball. Swimming in the mire, set the game as cargo to dimension me with fire. I'm tricked in where the current shows, floating on my back. The chance of use my body, I stomach my side. So I felt the bubble form somewhere below my skin. Oh, the game is fighting for charm. I remove the ghost away. Removed the mask and caused the minus two. The antibody responded, taking turns at grabbing her. The foggy caverns, musty grime appeared within my mind. I grabbed this book to scream it off. Back. be afraid. And you see what I'm hunting for, you set me free. But I take a wrong turn and I'm on the wrong path. The people are watching me to a new life. We'll be right back. the mouth and wipes away the beads of sweat that glisten on his brow. His tired feet were buried in the quagmire, and his bloodshot eyes saw all that lay between him and fulfillment of his vow. And he felt his fingers wrap around his body root and pull his body upwards to a seaweed mossy boulder, and he dragged his weary shit ass up the mountain. We'll be right back. start from somewhere before you can really go anywhere. So the way I want to start here before we go anywhere is basically from where everybody's standing here. The best thing to do is just start off by getting yourself firmly planted on the ground. So if we can all kind of just, the way to do that is kind of feel your feet in the place they're on the ground and just kind of concentrate on that for a minute. So feel yourself with your feet on the ground. And as you stand there feeling that, try to feel the weight of your body leaning on your feet. And you'll start to feel a little bit more grounded, you know, connected with the earth, connected with everything all around you. So we're all standing, our feet are on the ground. And what you can do now with your eyes closed or open is picture yourself just kind of from right around the outside of your head, standing there on the floor. And kind of raise up above yourself just a little bit. And you can start to see down from above yourself and the person standing on either side of you and what that would look like from above. So you're standing there and you feel the earth, feel your feet on the ground. Just lift up a little bit. And look down. Try to see the people standing on either side of you, the tops of their heads. They might be wearing a hat. They might have a funny looking hair, a certain colored shirt. And as you're doing that, just start to lift up a little bit more from that spot. And look down. Now you might see a few more people come into view. And you're feeling yourself. And a few more people, and slowly starting to rise up a little bit higher out of your body. And you're leaving your body behind now. And lifting up in the air. Now you can see the whole group of people down below you, kind of a mass. You can see a soundboard from the top and maybe the stage. Four of us sitting up here making this funny sound. And you go higher and higher until you're right up against the roof of the building. So now, as we're talking, we've got all of our spirits pressed up against the building. We can kind of feel the outside of the building pulsating to let us through. And this is going to be kind of softly, we start to ooze through the building. And now, if you can picture lifting up higher and higher, you can see the building down below you. Kind of picture the road leading up to the building, and there's some people milling about around the building on the outside, and certain people that maybe didn't get in, and they're kind of going to join us here outside. And we're lifting up higher and higher. You start to see the other field house over there where all the teams play, and the main road there, and you see little bodies of water coming into view as you're getting higher, and trees and forests, and you're getting higher and higher, and the higher you go, the more. Now you start to lift even higher, and it starts to get a little blurry down there until you can sort of see the curvature of the earth. And just lifting up and lifting up until lifting up and kind of going up, and now you see the earth and drifting off into space. And the whole time, your head is up here floating in space, but your feet are more planted on the ground than they've ever been. And at this point in time, just in our minds, start to take that one step forward with our feet that are planted on the ground. And as we step forward, and
we fall into a huge hole! Oh my God, we're falling down a hole!
But this isn't the kind of hole that I fell in yesterday. So, you're not gonna all end up retorting with these vandals, because this is the pleasure hole. So now we drifted down the hole. And it's just like pillows and sedges, and you're never gonna hit the bottom because it's just the soft falling down into the thing, deeper and deeper, falling into the blackness. And you're falling, and instead of hitting, crashing onto the bottom on the cement, breaking your ankle, you fall out and you kind of drift off into this black, jet black darkness. Starts to get a little teeny bit bigger, and it turns into a dot. And the dot is floating in front of his face, and it's looking like a little ball. And it comes closer and closer, and now it starts to look like it's sort of a square or a rectangle, but with an angle. And as it comes around, it tilts over until you see it sort of as a plane going off in the distance, and you see that it's bright green. It's a bright green plane floating towards you, and the closer you get to it, it starts to fill up your whole entire field of vision until you see that it's really grass spreading off in the distance with trees and lawn, and then mountains rising up in the other direction over there. And you look down and you realize that you've fallen through the hole. He's climbing up the mountain to find the great and knowledgeable Icarus. And he's going to ask Icarus to call up the famous mockingbird. And the famous mockingbird is going to come flying down out of the sky and land on Icarus' shoulder. Icarus is going to whisper into the famous mockingbird's ear, go fly to the king, evil King Wilson's castle, steal the helping friendly book, bring it back to the people of Gamehenge, thereby setting them free with peace and tranquility forever and ever. So here he comes now, the famous mockingbird. Thank you.
Let's sing. Let me be back.
say.
Oh, Baseball.
I'm going to go 0-3 there tonight.
Bad shots if you want to make a match.
Thank you.
his understudy, Brad, the guy who throws the balls out.
Thank you. Thank you. Riding down the road one day, someone advised
was running down the road.